JVP parliamentarian Sunil Handunetti spoke on the debt burden of the country at a meeting held in Gampaha yesterday.
Now they have constructed highways. That's good. There is nothing wrong in building the roads. But the road constructed is 172 kilometers long. The revenue from 2013 is 27 billion rupees. But now they are constructing one from Godagama, Mathura to Beliyatta. It is 96 kilometers long. We got hold of the feasibility study on the estimations yesterday. The feasibility study was done during Mahinda Rajapaksa's time, and it says the revenue of this highway will be minus 1,171 million US dollars. This will bring losses to the country if this is built. How much was it? Close to 1,200 million US dollars. But this was swept under the carpet and the highway was constructed. Loans are obtained from China Exim Bank. Do you know how the estimations were made? It said during the years 2015, 16 and 17, this will generate a revenue of 683 billion rupees. But not a single ticket was issued during the last 5 years. They have not even constructed the highway yet, but we have already estimated an income of 683 billion rupees. But the losses that might incur is calculated as minus 1,270 million dollars. When you added the income that has not yet been earned, you will have to deduct that 683 billion rupees. The revenue of the recently constructed expressway is 27 billion rupees. Who estimated that an additional income could be earned by issuing tickets for 4 to 5 years? The Central Expressway is also the same. The water projects implemented with the funds raised from China and India are also the same. They exaggerate the estimations and determine the debt. Do you know why? Although there is an interest rate of 2%, Sri Lanka has to pay a commitment fee when we obtain loans from foreign banks. People of this country know the list of things we can do in a school with 100,000 rupees. How many classrooms can be built? How many desks and chairs can we purchase? There are so many playgrounds that need to be built. There are so many dispensaries with no medicine. There are principals who come to us asking for 25,000 rupees from the decentralized fund. Nobody pays attention to these things.